For this week's activity, you will learn how to quantify bacteria in a sample. That means determining how many bacteria there are. To do this, you will first add TSB medium to Eppendorf tubes, then collect a sample and put it in the first tube. If you were to spread the resulting liquid sample on a plate, there would be too many bacteria to count. To obtain a countable plate, you will prepare a serial dilution of your sample, spread the liquid from each of the tubes in the series on a separate plate, incubate the plates, determine which plate is countable, count the colonies, and use that number to calculate the number of bacteria in your original tube.
Gather your supplies. You will need 6 TSA plates, 600 microliters of TSA, 6 Eppendorf tubes, 1 spreader, 1 pipetter, 7 tips, and 1 cotton swab. First, you will wash your hands, disinfect your work area, label the TSA plates with the date, your initials, and the name of the medium. The dilutions will be 10 to the negative 1, 10 to the negative 2, 10 to the negative 3, 10 to the negative 4, 10 to the negative 5, and 10 to the negative 6. Label the Eppendorf tubes with the same dilutions. Set your pipetter to 100 microliters. Pipette 100 microliters of TSB into the first Eppendorf tube. You will then pipette 90 microliters into each of the remaining Eppendorf tubes. You may use the same tip for this step. Take your swab and moisten it with water and collect bacteria from a kitchen sponge, the floor, or a pet's water bowl. Once you've collected your sample, mix the sample into the TSA tube labeled 10 to the negative 1. Gently move the cotton swab up and down to mix the sample with the medium and then discard the swab. Set the pipetter to 10 microliters. Be sure to stay at the first stop. Remember, only go to the second stop when you are trying to eject all of the liquid and leave the tube at the end. Notice how when you have such a small volume, the first stop is a very tiny movement. Take 10 microliters from the 10 to the negative 1 tube and transfer it to the second tube labeled 10 to the negative 2. Mix with the pipette by moving the liquid up and down with the first stop until you have mixed 5 to 8 times. Empty the tip by going to the second stop and discard the tip. Continue this process, moving 10 microliters from each tube, going from the negative 2 to the negative 3, the negative 3 to the negative 4, and so on, using a new tip each time. Once you have completed the serial dilution, you are ready to transfer the liquid to the matching plates. From now, you will work starting from the most dilute, which is the 10 to the negative 6, backward to the least dilute, which is 10 to the negative 1. That way you can use the same tip and spreader as you work. In between use, place the pipette and the spreader on the edge of the tube rack. Be careful, don't allow your spreader or pipette tip to touch any surface. Set the pipetter to 100 microliters. Remove 100 microliters, which will be all of the liquid, from the 10 to the negative 6 Eppendorf tube, and gently empty the entire amount onto the 10 to the negative 6 TSA plate on top of the agar. Use the spreader to move the sample over the entire surface of the agar. Be gentle so you don't break the agar. Place the spreader over the edge of the tube rack using the handle to secure it. Be careful not to let the end touch any other surface in order to avoid contamination. Continue to transfer each sample in the same manner in this order, 10 to the negative 5, 10 to the negative 4, 10 to the negative 3, and so on, until you finally reach 10 to the negative 1. Store your plates agar side up, clean your workspace, Throw away the tips, the spreader, and the empty Eppendorf tubes. Disinfect your workspace and wash your hands.